up, man?
Good, man. How you doing?
I'm good, man. Big day coming up, man. May 23rd, 15-year anniversary of Eminem's Marshall Mathers LP, man. I can't believe it was 15 years ago. Do you remember what was going on 15 years ago when this LP dropped?
M, you know, he was off his first, you know, official big album, Slim Shady LP, and he was already the biggest thing in music, basically. This came out, it sold almost 2 million in the first week. But it was also a very controversial album, as he's been for the last 15 years, a controversial figure. His lyrics, some of the things that he said, you know, whether it's misogynistic things, violent things, killing his wife, homophobic things. People were, you know, picketing, as he says in one of the lines, picket signs from our Wicked Rhymes, you know? Yeah. But at the same time, almost 2 million people are coming out and buying it. So it was this really divisive album. And here we are 15 years later, and we're still talking about it. What were some of your favorite moments or songs?
Oh, man, my favorite song probably just has to be Stan. And I hate to sound cliche and always go with the single, but Stan, I remember the first time I heard it, made the hairs in the back of my neck stand up. It's just one of the greatest story rhymes ever in hip-hop history, with the twist at the end. And we still talk about Stan, right? Like, if somebody's a super fan, they're a Stan. Like, 15 years later, like, that's in the vernacular. Yeah. That's in our slang. That's in our dictionary.
Something that he does in that song, which he does a few times on the album, you know, Who Knew and The Way I Am, is these examinations of fame and kind of his role and his responsibility. And, you know, a lot of rappers, they talk about fame when they get famous, of course. But M always found a way to do it in a particularly pointed way. And it was also interesting, given the wild things that he was saying, kind of him thinking about his responsibility and others' responsibility in society and some of the hypocrisy of society. So I always thought that that was really great and interesting.
Another moment that I really loved was Remember Me with RBX and Sticky Fingers, only for the fact because there's people who debate whether or not Sticky Fingers out-rhymed Eminem, and nobody ever debates that. I still think M got him, but it was pretty close. Like, Sticky wasn't no slouch, and that was a great show of lyricism all around.
Right. You know, it sounds like both of us still love a lot of these songs, or, you know, the whole album. Do you feel like it stands the test of time here 15 years later?
Does Marshall Mathers LP stand the test of time? Ultimately, yes, I think it does. But when it came out in the year 2000, it stuck out like a sore thumb. It didn't sound like anything else. It was Eminem and Dre's sound that they built together, and then M kind of mastered on this second album. So it was nothing like anything else. It didn't fit in then. It was just this dope Eminem record that was solely his. And I think 15 years later, I don't think there's been anything like it. I still think it's Eminem's sound. So it kind of fits in the same place that it fit 15 years ago. It's hard to say if it aged well, because hip hop is obviously in this trap phase and wherever it's at now. But the album then didn't fit in what was going on in the year 2000 anyway. So I just think it's an Eminem album, and in his discography, it's the greatest.
Right.
What do you think, man? Do you think it's timeless? Has it stood the test of time?
You know, it's a complicated thing for me. I was in, I think it was the end of my sixth grade year when it came out. I remember getting it and loving it. But some of the things that he says on it, now as I'm older, they do trouble me, and I wonder how I would feel if it came out now. But at the time, and still now, I just marvel at his technical ability, and I'm never gonna get past that. I think he is one of, if not the greatest, when it comes to that stuff. So in that sense, I still listen back, I love it, and I think it does stand the test of time for me.
All right, man, that's what it is, man. I'll see you in another 15 years, man.
Yeah, man.
Nah, we're probably gonna do this again another 5. We're gonna do this for the 20-year anniversary.
Might have to.
Maybe something bigger, but for now, we're gonna go bump the LP, enjoy it, May 23rd, Marshall Mathers LP.